Zaragon here. I have assimilated more than 17,000 albums from around the world in my 35 years as a music connoisseur. To explore the journey in depth, see the Trimax Music Database on RYM and the Directory of American Bands on jazzrocksoul.com, both linked in the description below. While you're at it, hit the like and subscribe buttons and the bell and share this video. Today, we're going to examine a few tracks by three different brass rock bands from the United States circa 1970. Yes, a year that brass rock was everywhere in the wake of Chicago and Blood, Sweat, and Tears. And the first of those bands is Dreams with the track Try Me. We'll be right back. okay, Try Me by Dreams. I was just overwhelmed by the sheer musicianship and just the onslaught of rapid fire playing by those involved. Starting off with drummer Bill Cobham. Yes, the Bill Cobham, who would go on to really big things with Mahavishnu Orchestra, and then as a solo recording artist, putting out a string of great jazz funk albums in the mid to later part of the decade. And the brass assault of the Brecker Brothers, yes, getting their start off, trading, you know, charts here, interlocking with trombonist Barry Rogers, who played with Eddie Palmieri, and the just nimble frontal bass lines of Doug Lubon, who played on the Prime albums by The Doors, kind of like the band's fifth wheel, and Clear Light and a bunch of, yeah, all these musicians, very accomplished. And Edward Vernon on vocals there. Anyway, let's hear another track off this Dreams album, New York. Thank you.
all day, you work all day. And
echoey sound of a subway. That's New York by Brass Rockers Dreams from their 1970 self-titled album. And I'm just taken away by the rapid-fire snare rolls of Bill Cobham and the kind of jerky, like, stop-start, you know, syncopations of the main frame of the track. And the way that soprano sax kept on, like, trailing that part. And I must also give props to guitarist Jeff Kent, who came in and staked his claim toward the end there. Yeah, he had some really just lilting moments in the prior track. One that almost kind of, like, startled me. Yeah, he went on to much later to play in a metal band, the House of Lords. This track, this band, they've got like the horn charts that would make the guys in Chicago envious. They've got this snappy syncopated groove factor that would make a Tower of Power take notice. And they've even got moments of, like, dissonance that would leave the Global Unity Orchestra in awe. Yeah, talk about talent. Okay, now on to another brass rock band from the U.S. circa 1970. This is Gas Mask from their singular self-titled album, the track If You Just Think of Me.
You can tell me everything. seems to match ya. Holler with you every day. Holler that I'll hold you tight, ya. When I'm away, baby, just think of me. When I'm away for a holiday, almost. Oh, baby, just think of me. Oh, never be apart, no, never be apart, my love.
If You Just Think of Me by Gas Mask, kind of a very brassy, reedy soul rocker. Yeah, and the vocals are done by Bobby Osborne. Best known for this album, and no other credits according to Discogs. In group, the Del Airs, 10 years beforehand. And surprisingly, this band, though American, they count among their ranks Enrico Rava, the famed Italian jazzman. Trumpeter, and I've profiled him before, but that video got blocked by YouTube. You'll have to go over to Cocoscope to see it. And some other talented players. Reedist Richard Grondo, who played with Earth Opera, and keyboardist Nick Olivia, played on the 1972 Dr. Hooker album. Saxophonist David Gross, who played on some 80s era albums with Bob Moses, prolific jazzman. Yeah, and yeah, The Gas Mask, another one of those albums with by a big like 8-piece band with a very with a cover that you just cannot miss. And now the next song by Gas Mask, The Immigrant.
Thank you.
every last note counts. Yeah, wailing away, that fluttering away. That was The Immigrant by Gas Mask, and that, as you can tell, was a showcase for Enrico Rava, just blowing and billowing and just squeezing as many notes as possible out of his trumpet. And over like a repetitive, like organ-based progression and some reed charts, quite effective. And I must also point out the drum rolls of James Strasberg, who would also play on the Gotham album from 1972, Past the Butter. I've profiled that album. Yeah, great, great release. His only two credits, but two really good ones. And anyway, now on to the last band of the set, The Second Coming, with Nobody Cares. Okay, Nobody Cares by The Second Coming. And it started out as like another fine soul rocker, and then it loosened up and went into that jazzy middle amid that walking bass line and some more like expressionistic horn charts and such. And the main things, this track, written by keyboardist Dave Miller, the chief composer of the band, who plays a Wurlitzer electric piano and Hammond on the album. And what really stood out to me, though, was the horn charts arranged by Bill Dinwiddie, who would later play on albums by Hartsfield and the Leigh Hooper Big Band, among others, and Chuck Mangione. And some good drum rolls by Les King, apparently no other credits according to Discogs, sadly. And, oh yeah, that walking bass line took over in the middle. Two bassists are credited, Ernie Sell and Tom Palmer. Yeah, anyway, let's hear another track from this album, Requiem for a Rainy Day.
Mr. Day, little well, Mr. Rain, can I stay?
Well, upping that, just harmonic quotient right there toward the end. Yeah. Requiem for a Rainy Day by The Second Coming, and that track just started out like as this great, you know, soul rocker, and then it got more like brassy and complicated as things went on and intricate. And we had the very moving vocals of Buddy Stevens taking the lead, and writer Dave Miller was a bit more prominent instrumentally on this number, taking some leads on that organ of his, and some more great drum fills by the sadly little recorded Lay King, and the brass just interlocking throughout most of it once again. And Jack Kramer, the trumpeter, followed Dinwiddie to Hartsfield, and then played on some late 70s notable soul records by Kitty and the Haywoods and Soul Funksters' Phase O, their two late 70s albums, Phase O of Riding High fame. Anyway, yeah, I love this second, coming cover. It's like this foamy blue multi-eyed living thing spread out over a red curtain, kind of like the missing link between psychedelia and Kenny Scharf or Keith Haring. Yeah, anyway, brass rock at the nexus between many styles circa 1970, a bit of blues rock, a bit of jazz, a bit of pop, soul, rock, and on thriving on both sides of the Atlantic, you know, stateside with these bands, Second Coming, Gas Mask, and Dreams, as well as, you know, Ten Wheel Drive, the Sons of Champlin, and Ambergris, and Tower of Power, and on up to the big names like Chicago, Blood, Sweat, and Tears, Lighthouse, Over the Border, the Ides of March, and over in England with bands like If, Galliard, The Greatest Show on Earth, Brainchild. Yeah, I've covered those acts. Anyway, for more Rubies and Sapphires from the three bands that we've just heard, and many others in this vein, see the directory of albums from 1970, linked in the description below for Red Hot Tracks and Purples from more than 900 albums from 1970. Great start to an enormous decade. Like and subscribe, follow me on social media, share the video, and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the six songs and the three bands that we just heard. Who was your favorite? Yeah, who had the best, which track had the best break, the best horn charts, the best, you know, organ runs, the best bass licks, the best rhythmic grooves, was just the most soulful and emotive and powerful and dynamic. Yeah. And until next time, this is Zaragon, the world's most ear travel trimaximalist, signing off.